Our world is changing due to the COVID-19 crisis. Far beyond its tragic human cost, the truth is this pandemic and the necessary lockdown measures have resulted in a profound disruption of economic activity throughout the globe. In the case of Spain, at the beginning of 2020, we were on a sound growth path that had lasted more than 5 years. With the eruption of the pandemic, we took fast and firm measures in order to protect human lives, including a very strict lockdown. We also put in place different instruments to maintain jobs, help businesses' liquidity, and support households' income, protecting in particular the most vulnerable. Those measures have proven to be critical to sustain activity, to minimize the cost of the crisis, and avoid a structural impact. After the sharp GDP drop in the second quarter of the year, our latest indicators point to a steady recovery in the third quarter, with GDP growth around 13%, which should pave the way for a strong recovery in 2021. If this pandemic is a tunnel, we cannot exit through the same place we entered. We need to ensure that recovery is not only strong, but also more sustainable from the financial, social and environmental point of view. Fortunately, this time around, the European Union has acted in an agile manner to provide a common response, both in the short run with ample liquidity and public financing instruments, and in the long run with a recovery and resilience facility which will be key to support the twin green and digital transitions. As you know, Europe and its member states have decided on an extremely powerful recovery package, which would add 2 to 3 percentage points to GDP growth in Spain already in 2021, thanks to the future-oriented reforms and investment supported by this new fund. This would be on top of the already strong rebound forecasted for our country for next year and lead to strong job creation. Maybe more importantly, these investments would support a deep transformation of our productive system and address the structural reforms that are long overdue. The President of the Spanish government presented just last week our national recovery plan based on 4 main pillars: the green transition, digital transformation, social and territorial cohesion, and closing the gender gap. The plan sets in place an ambitious agenda of investments and structural reforms amounting to around 72 billion euros in the 2021 to 2023 period, with 37% of the foreseen investment devoted to the green transition, with targeted large-scale interventions and projects to achieve our ambitious decarbonisation goals of zero emissions by 2050. The Spanish recovery plan includes investments to boost further development of renewable energy, to deploy more than 100,000 charging stations to foster clean mobility, to push for energy efficiency in more than 500,000 buildings, to enhance our water resources management, to fully develop a circular economy, amongst other projects. Another 33% of investment will be devoted to the twin digital transition, with investments and reforms in transformative policies such as connectivity and 5G deployment, enhancing digital skills of workers and citizens, the digitalization of SMEs, the digitalization of public services. We find ourselves at a crossroads, an opportunity to change the playing field. This is our chance to emerge from this crisis with more modern, more inclusive, more resilient economies from the financial, social, and environmental point of view. Urgent needs related to fighting the pandemic should not make us lose sight of the long-term challenges, which have not disappeared at all. We need to build back better. I would like to conclude by thanking the coalition for its work and contributions, which is absolutely key to this endeavor. We are making progress in mainstreaming climate change into economic policy, but much remains to be done. You can count on Spain's unwavering support in this endeavor. Thank you very much.